just letting everyone know that everything is fine, it's great, back on track, better than ever, right at the right time. And truly, the entire situation is becoming clarified for me to an extraordinary extent. Now, the extent that I can convey it, well, that takes a little bit of time. Patience is required. To get it into words, into a word picture, is a challenge for sure. But it basically, the continuity problem is the only problem we have. That is my technique. That's what I'm sharing with the world. The continuity problem is the only problem I have. It's the only problem anyone has. That's a fact. And what the technique of practice does is, what we do is we flatten everything out. All other problems get flattened out into this one problem, continuity problem. So I don't have a problem with death. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a problem with sickness. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a problem with finances. I have a continuity problem. This is the actual technique that is all powerful and super simple to use. I don't have a problem with whatever. I have a continuity problem. This is what arose this morning after another dream of having everything solved and resolved and flattened out. And obviously, situations are getting very good for me, very clear for me. So the technique that arose is, I don't have a problem, I don't have a body problem, I don't have a world problem, I don't have a war problem, I have a continuity problem. Now what this does is it places the problem where it really is, instead of displacing it. Now why is this so important? Because the root of the continuity problem is that we displaced the feeling of deprivation onto God. Now listen to this very carefully. These teachings will save you unbelievable amount of suffering and time suffering. You'll be able to flatten everything out. We as spirit, we wanted to be greater than God. We said, hey, let's be more than everything. So what in effect that does is, it's sort of like trying to push God out, trying to deprive God of what God is. Because we're one with God, and if we're one with God and we say, God, you're not one with us. We're greater than you are. We're really trying to deprive reality of reality. And as soon as we want it to be greater than reality, more than reality, this issue of deprivation immediately arose. Like we felt, oh my gosh, we're being deprived of reality. Now, in that instant, we decided, it was part of the dynamic of this idea, is to project, to misperceive where that feeling of deprivation, fear of deprivation was coming from. We projected it onto reality and said, God is trying to deprive us of reality. Not that we're trying to deprive God of reality, that God is trying to deprive us of reality. So we misplaced this fear of deprivation and said it's coming from God. As soon as we did that, then we're terrified of reality and God, as if God is persecuting us and chasing us, and we had to flee from that. We had this enormous fear, and we tried to, how do we escape this terrible fear that God is trying to deprive us of reality? Well, ask yourself that question. What do we do? What we did was we invented what's called the body, what's called the world. We invented all this. And we put all of our fear of deprivation into this little tiny body in order to shrink it down, to shrink our fear of deprivation down into just fear of losing this body. So this body is really a technique that we're using, a deprivation technique, to try to minimize the fear, this infinite fear we have of God is trying to deprive us of reality. Instead, now it's just God is trying to deprive us of the life of this body. You know, very tiny, 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 tiny little thing. So the body is something we have invented. And we identify with the body. And we say, yeah, We get up in the morning and say, oh my gosh, I got to get oxygen for the body. I've got to get food for the body. I've got to protect it from accidents and attack. I've got to get clothes and shelter for the body. And the body, so the body's in constant danger of deprivation, right? And so by focusing on the body, our fear tends to have a target for it. We're able to see the fear there, and we say, oh, well, that's a small little fear. It's not a big fear. The body, our fear is the body's going to be deprived. Not that spirit's going to be deprived of everything, but no, the body's going to be deprived of some food, but ultimately it's going to die. It's going to be deprived of, but it's a technique. This whole world is a technique that we have invented to try and shrink down the fear of God trying to deprive us of everything. Now, that's a misplacement, right? Totally unnecessary. But since we have been doing this for so long, we now have a continuity problem. We don't want to let go of it. We don't want to let go of bodies and worlds. We don't want to let go of thinking that we are this body with this world, or we don't want to just throw everything in the garbage and forget all about it. Not right away. Eventually we will, but not right away. So it's like we need a happy dream to replace this terrifying dream. How do we do that? By proper perception of where the problem is. Because the great issue we have is that we misperceived where the problem was, where this feeling of deprivation was coming from. It's coming from our desire to be greater than God, not from God's desire to crush us, to limit us, to deprive us. So the way to deal with this misperception, as it were, of what the problem is to start to correct, make a correction of where the problem is now, which is the continuity problem. We're so used to using the body as a technique to shrink our fear down that we can't imagine life without things and objects and body. In other words, the whole sphere of deprivation that we've imagined to form. So our problem is really the continuity problem. Because the other one, as far as seeing the silly mistake of blaming God for our fear of deprivation, that's easy to see that. It's easy. Not a problem for anyone. I should see that. It's the continuity problem is the problem we have now. So you say, I don't have a death problem. I have a continuity problem. Because without the continuity problem, we wouldn't give one second of thought to the bodies in the world. Not even one second of thought to it. So our problem is really the continuity problem. It is not any other problem whatsoever. And we can practice by saying, I don't have an aging problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a flu problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a body problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a vulnerability problem, I have a continuity problem. Because keep in mind that all this vulnerability that we have imagined and that we are sustaining in the imagination of mind is solely a fear-shrinking technique. But it's all based on misapplying where the fear is coming from, misperceiving where the fear is coming from. So it's all totally unnecessary. Totally unnecessary. If we see that it was our desire to deprive reality of what it is, that from our whim to be prime creator and not God at all, then there's no reason to fear God at all. Therefore, there's no reason to shrink down the fear at all. So therefore, there's no reason for bodies and things at all, right? But we're used to it, so we don't want to do that. First, we want to solve the continuity problem. So what we do when we say, I don't have a body problem, I don't have a world problem, I don't have a war problem, I don't have a relationship problem, I don't have a life problem, I have a continuity problem. It agrees with God. It puts you in agreement with God. It's honesty. It puts you in agreement. And then you are right at the place where God has the remedy. Because see, God doesn't have a remedy for this problem or that problem, because God knows that would only make things worse for us, thinking that, oh yeah, we really do need to shrink our fear down. God only has the answer to the continuity problem. That's it. So when you agree that the only problem I have is a continuity problem, you're in agreement with God. And then therefore your fear dissipates, your fear. And what does God do? God smooths out the entire situation here. Smooths it out for you. Smooths it out for you. No more rough edges. Everything gets smoothed out. And you feel like, wow, I don't have a feeling like I really have any problems at all. Now, you may wonder why people's have their lives have such rough edges to them. Because they're trying, that's what they want. They're desperate for that because they feel by focusing on these little minute dramas, you know, they can drown out this gigantic, infinite fear that they have. It's a matter of attention. They say, no, I got my attention on this soap opera and these little petty, you know, problems. And therefore, I'm not thinking about this that God is trying to deprive me of reality. And it's a technique they're using. And so if you tried to take away all their sickness and their struggling and their fears and all the troubles that the body brings, they would panic. They would absolutely panic and think you're attacking them. That's why God does not smooth out their lives. Your life gets smoothed out when you agree with God of what the problem really is. And so we need to practice this. We need to practice agreeing with God. And once we are able to do that, then God is able to apply the sovereign remedy, which smooths out everything equally. Everything is equally smoothed out. So nothing seems to be a problem. Death is not a problem. Sickness is not a problem. Old age is not a problem. Loneliness is not a problem. Nothing's a problem. Everything feels smoothed out. So beautiful and smoothed out. But that will only come to us when we agree with God what the problem really is that we have. Because we can't say, hey God, you know, you're trying to deprive me of something and can you stop trying to deprive me? No, that doesn't work. That doesn't work. We have to say, God, I made a mistake in thinking that you were trying to deprive me of something. So I've made all this stuff to try and shrink that fear down. And now I realize I don't need any of this stuff. But I'm afraid to set it all down. So can you please smooth it out for me? And God says, yes, that's exactly right. That's exactly right. So you're on the same page. You're on the same page as God. That is the way to do it. That is what the Holy Spirit has shown me. That's what my clarifications have led me to. Now, this is different teaching than most teachers. That's fine. But this is, I am certain that this is the sovereign, simple way which saves an incredible amount of time for everybody because it's easy to simply say, hey, I don't have a this problem. I don't have a people problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a people problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an anger problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't even have a fear problem. I have a continuity problem. Which is, there's levels there, right? Don't get into level confusion because continuity problem is a trepidation. But it's specifically we need to say, I don't have a fear of death problem. I have a continuity problem. So wrap up all the problems and see them actually as you've been misperceiving what your problems are because you actually have one problem. Only have one problem. That's the continuity problem. Flattens everything out. Once everything's flattened out that way, it's easy for then God to show you this vision of smoothness, to smooth out everything that seems incredibly smooth in your life. Grace, you live a life of grace at that time. Once you accept that the only problem you've ever had and ever will have is a continuity problem. Because God is not trying to deprive us of everything. Now those who believe, who are working on trying to shrink the fear down so it's not so severe, they of course insist that God made bodies, God made death, God made this world, God made all this stuff, and so this is what life is, etc. In other words, all this shrinking down of the fear onto bodies is somehow divinely mandated, and that's the way. It's not the way. It's not the way at all. That's the way that doesn't work. That's the way that absolutely doesn't work. So, you can say, I don't have a God problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a body problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a life problem, I have a continuity problem. It's ridiculous. When we wake up in the morning, it's ridiculous. We say, okay, but how am I going to get this body through the day? that's the thought, like, oh my gosh, I've got to drag this body through the day. Again, why do we even have bodies? Only because we're trying to displace our dreadful fear of deprivation from God onto the bodies and say, oh no, the fear of deprivation is only coming because I'm trying to keep this body alive. That's where it's really coming from. You see, it's another misplacement, isn't it? It's another misplacement. We're used to displacements. We displace this fear of deprivation onto God from where it really came from, of us trying to deprive God. We displaced it onto God. And now we displace this fear of deprivation on to try to shrink it down. We displaced it onto the body. And now it's like, okay, how do I get this body through the day? That's only what's happening. That's it. So these are the central dynamics. And all you have to do is to practice saying, I don't have a time problem, I have a continuity problem. Whatever arises as a problem for you, and there's some things will be stickier than others. If there's something too sticky, don't struggle with it. Don't struggle with it. Like, my problem is, how do I get these videos, mixing some other video with them and sync up the... it's impossible, you know, without a ton of work, actually. It's so difficult. So I said, forget that. Don't worry about that. Just if something arises that's just too difficult, to set it aside and say, okay, I don't have a death problem. I have a continuity problem, something like that. I don't have a life problem. I got a continuity problem. I don't have a vulnerability problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an aging problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a sickness problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a high blood pressure problem, I have a continuity problem. Whatever problem that that rises up to you, start practicing it. And again, if something is too difficult, just say, okay, I'll do that a little later when I get better at this. It's like when you start exercising, you say, well, I'm not gonna run a marathon right away, but I'm gonna do what I can do, I'll start walking. Start flattening out everything, all the problems you think you have. Start flattening them out, like an aluminum can. Flatten the can out so you can recycle it. Because once you flatten all these problems out, then you'll look around and you say, whoa, there's not some monstrous cityscape of problems. It's just all flat. And then it's easy, and you say, oh, I can accept this, a smooth out of all this flatness. That's not a problem. So what we're doing is we're getting in agreement with God, getting into agreement with God. That is the key. Because God tells us the only problem we have is a continuity problem. So when we get into agreement with that and practice our agreement, I'm telling you, you are right there. You will be saved from this dread of deprivation, which is really at the root of all our troubles, this terrible fear. And we don't need to tackle this fear because it's completely bogus. It's completely bogus, right? So all we need to do is to tackle the continuity problem, and God has already done that for us. So all we need to do is agree with God that the only problem we have is a continuity problem. That's it. Don't struggle with the fear. Say, I don't have a fear problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have a problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have problems. I have one problem, the continuity problem. There aren't any problems in the world. There's only the continuity problem. This is agreeing with God. And your fear of God will evaporate. And then you won't be afraid to accept God's smoothing out of your life. Entirely smoothing out. Everything is smoothed out. So I'm saying that all this came to me very clearly. And first, the dream was super clear. And then I woke up and I began thinking about it. Then it's a little less clear. And then I tried to explain it, which gets it even less clear. So the very fact that I'm able to explain this verbally, not to in my being, in order to even, you know, speak like this, because it's very difficult to try and paint a word picture. So it definitely is extremely clear to me what's really going on. And then in the world, it becomes much more murky, right, as you try to convey it to others. But within you, I'm sure you can see it for yourself way more clearly than words can convey. And say, I don't have a word problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a clarity problem even. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a communication problem. I have a continuity problem. Same for everybody. Nobody has, so you don't need to solve communication problems. You don't need to solve relationship problems. You don't need to solve even love problems. I don't have a love problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a heart problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have, whatever it is, turn it around and say, it's just a continuity, actually, it's only a continuity problem that I have trouble with. And everybody's the same. So you don't need, nobody needs to solve any problems at all for anybody. Because we only have one problem, and that's the continuity problem, and God has solved that for us. We only need to accept it. We only need to agree with God. That's it. And remember, our original problem is disagreeing with God about where the feeling of deprivation was coming from. We said, no, God, it's not coming from me, it's coming from you. That's the original sin. All we had to do is say, oh, yeah. It's coming because I wanted to be greater than you. That's why, obviously, the feeling of deprivation is I'm trying to deprive myself of reality. So, of course, it's coming from me. And then there never would have been any issue whatsoever. But we said, no, God, it's coming from you. So we need to get back in agreement with God and say, hey, God, I made this whimsical mistake, and now I have a continuity problem. And then God says, exactly right. We're on the same page now, just like that. Incredibly simple, incredibly easy. I don't have a spiritual path problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a technique problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a delay problem. I have a continuity problem. Flatten everything out. This is the technique. This has been going on for over a week now in my dreams. Is every night I get the answer in my dreams that I see that this is it. It's solved. And then when I wake up in the morning, it gets murky. Or I try desperately to figure out how do I convey it to people. But I've been working on graphics, trying to make some incredible graphics, you know. And it's just, everything is blocked. It's unbelievable. I've been blocked for 3 days. Nothing on the computer works properly. I can't get any programs to work right. Nothing is the most amazing thing. And finally, I woke up this morning and said, forget it, forget it. Just convey the simple truth to people. You know, but I want it to be clearer, because of course it's going to be murky, but that's unavoidable. It's unavoidable. So emphasis on practice. And say, I don't have a ... problem. I have a continuity problem as you go through the day. I don't have a life problem. I have a continuity problem. And as you come up, you'll come up with more and more and more and more of the day. Just try to say it to yourself, even say it out loud as you're driving or whatever you are. And this is the sovereign technique. This is gets you into agreement with God. And literally, once you actually try this and apply it and start using it, you will see that you will not have another incarnation. You will not be, you won't need the body anymore. After this body is set down, you won't need the body anymore. You won't need a fear-shrinking device, a distraction device, thinking that this is where your fear is coming from in order to try and avoid more gigantic fear. This is a classical thing we do when we're overloaded with a gigantic fear. We try to shrink it down and project it on something else and say, this is where my trouble is. This little thing here is where my trouble is. This little body, that's my trouble, not this gigantic fear. This is something that we do. It's a defensive measure. So all of this has arisen as a defensive measure against this gigantic fear. Once we see the gigantic fear is totally unfounded, what do we need all this for? Only for the sake of continuity. God knows that. God won't take this away from us. Smooth it out. smooth it out. Pour oil over the whole world, smooth it out, as it were. So just get in agreement, practice getting in agreement with God. I don't have a God problem, I have a continuity problem. All right, that's it.